Well, things didn't quite go as planned. Somewhere between halfway up the mountain and all the way up the mountain, the magazine to my rifle popped out with my 5 rounds in them. And I backtracked trying to locate it, didn't do it. So, let this be a lesson. Bring extra magazines. Bring some extra bullets. Because now, luckily it's not too far, I get to drive back to my house to go get another magazine that I have in my safe. And then come back out. So, slight delay. We'll be back out. It's pretty windy already. Anyways, it's been raining all day. Sometimes hard kind of lull right now, but real foggy. Visibility's dropped to like, right now it's not as bad, but when I was up at the top of the mountain, the visibility was probably, I don't know, 30 yards. So not seeing much anyway. So if there was a day that I had to go make up for my amateur hour mistake, today's the day. So head home, go pick up that magazine, and we'll resume later. All day. As soon as I get out of the truck, as if to welcome me back to the woods that I left yesterday, rain starts again. So, let's make the best of it. Today I'm taking it nice and slow. Just gonna keep moving. Started down there at that field, and I'm just slowly making my way up this mountain on this side. A couple steps. It's just a bit too windy today. I think they're probably bedded down up in this kind of stuff here. And you're not going to see them unless you move through and try and spook them. I was hoping to catch them coming up this way. Up this finger. Back into that stuff where they bed. I just think it's been too windy today that they haven't been moving much. But it's still sunset, which means there's about 40 minutes of legal light left, but there's a real steep section of this mountain that I came up over back behind me that I need to get across before it's too dark, so I'm just about to start backing up and moving that way nice and slow for a little bit in case I do come across something coming up here, but it's looking like about time to back it up and start moving out. Thank you.
It's tough. This fog is pretty thick. It's like a double-edged sword. So, like, I can move quieter, and it's harder to pick up on my movement. But same for the deer. It's hard to see through this. I mean, really, there could be a deer up there 40, 50 yards away, and I wouldn't be able to tell unless it got up and ran. But we got to make do with the conditions we're given. So I'm gonna continue hiking up this mountain, see what it's like up there. Probably gonna spend all day up there until Nathan shows up at camp, depending on what time he can come. Good thing for that squirrel, I'm not squirrel hunting. Got a little close for it. It's about the only thing moving around here right now, though. This place is loaded with squirrels. That view I was talking about yesterday, this is it today. Whew. Look at that. In the clouds. Way below me, in a different section. I'm wondering completely soaked my boots, my socks, my pants. Rain jacket works, but everything else is soaked. I decided to change plans a little and come in here and hopefully catch the deer moving over to this side up there or vice versa. There's a lot of trails, there are a lot of game trails. I followed a lot of fresh deer tracks in here. So I hope to catch one moving this evening. And Nathan should be getting here probably within an hour. But he's on his own. That's where I'm gonna be. Let's see what happens.
Morning of the last day. Getting a late start, but it was raining all night and we were kind of both sick of sitting in the rain. It's about 8:30. We had a bear encounter last night come through our camp, wreak havoc. Not really, but he tried to get in our coolers, didn't get it, but he snagged a trash bag out of the back of Nathan's truck and took it up the hill. Nothing in there, but anyways, so we're gonna go hike up this mountain
last day
and then see what happens, man. Last day to make it happen. Here we go again with the fog. So it's supposed to start raining in about 30 minutes. We're gonna string a little shelter up, post up, and hopefully something walks by between now and dark. So hopefully it'll stay dry at least. But visibility's back to about 50 yards. So we're gonna have to get close. Well, we're in the spot we're gonna spend. 8 hours at. It's supposed to rain.
those hours, but we are set. We got a shelter put up. We got a jet boil for a hot lunch. Ready to wait out the weather and hopefully see a buck. The fog is rolling in. The temperature feels like it's plummeted. And you got this dude. Sure what it was, but we just heard something coming up through here, like hitting the trees and knocking all the water off of them onto the ground. It did it like 3 or 4 times, so I snuck over here real slow and real quiet. Nathan's still over in our little makeshift blind. See if splitting up and covering two different sides of this is going to increase our eyes here. We're coming down to basically the last hour, so if it's gonna happen, it's gonna happen now.